and gentlemen, and welcome to Pepsi Stadium on the campus of North Greenville University, where Christ makes the difference. For today's regular season match between the Southern Virginia University Knights and your North Greenville Crusaders. For today's starting lineups, first for the visiting Knights. At midfield, number 2, Rainey Whitworth. At defense, number 5, Faith Park. At attack, number 6, Michaela Knoll. At attack, number 7, Claire Hoodling. At defense, number 8, Chloe Lewis. At midfield, number 10, Zoe Bradshaw. At midfield, number 13, Ashley Aldridge. At midfield, number 14, Emily Lamb. At attack, number 15, Megan Barfoss. At defense, number 17, Elizabeth Brown. At goalkeeper, number 32, Rachel Miller. And at defense, number 26, Leah Smith. The Knights are coached by Nancy Weber and assisted by Susan Wager and Samantha Jones. And now, the starting lineup for your North Greenville Crusaders. At goalkeeper, number 2, Sydney Taylor. At attack, number 5, Sarah Smith. At defense, number 6, Rebecca Bagwell. At defense, number 7, Hannah Hawkins. Candace Pettit. At midfield, number 10, Emily Colson. At midfield, number 11, Monica Caldwell. At defense, number 13, Elizabeth Carey. At attack, number 15, Taylor Kennington. At attack, number 18, Taylor Haynes. Midfield, number 24, Natalie Dufresne. And at defense, number 29, Samantha Poppleton. Your Crusaders are coached by Brianna Temple. She is assisted by Lindsay Schneider. At this time, we ask that you please rise for the invocation and remain standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father God, thank you for this beautiful day you've given us outside. Keep all the players safe, Lord, and let them play for your glory, Lord, and the ability that you have given them. This is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
And welcome everyone back to Pepsi Stadium for some lacrosse action as the Southern Virginia University Knights have made the trip down to Tigerville to take on the North Greenville University Lady Crusaders here at Pepsi Stadium. It's uncharacteristically warm for a lacrosse game here in Tigerville. Grace Hull and Dave Parsons set to bring you an exciting matchup, a non-conference action between North Greenville and Southern Virginia. For North Greenville, some headlines coming into today's game. Sarah Smith named Conference Carolina's Player of the Week last week after her performance in the Erskine game. North Greenville scored 16 total goals in that game. So number five, Sarah Smith, to keep an eye, a player to keep an eye on for North Greenville. For the Lady Knights, look no further than number two, Rainey Whitworth, a senior out of Savannah, Georgia. She's got 18 goals on the season for the Lady Knights. They bring a 3-2 overall record into today's game. North Greenville sitting at 3-3. After losing their first three to start the season, then picking up three straight wins. And looking to go over 500 here in this game today. Back in the net for North Greenville, number two, Sydney Taylor. She has done well in her freshman campaign for North Greenville. And for the Lady Knights, number 32, Rachel Miller.
Have a beautiful day today. We thank those that have come out to watch in person and those of you that are watching us via the internet on the North Greenville University Sports Network. And we're ready to go.
At the line for the draw, Candace Pettit for North Greenville. And we're underway. And it's quickly picked up by number 10 for the Lady Knights, Zoe Bradshaw. She's second in scoring for this team. Bradshaw trying to take it right down the middle. Runs into a couple of defenders. And now tries again, loses the ball. And kind of slings a backwards pass that's scooped up by Whitworth. Here's Whitworth, she'll try down the middle. Monica Caldwell comes up to defend her for North Greenville, as well as Pettit, who dropped back after the draw. Now here's a pass underneath. This shot sails over the head of number 14, Emily Lamb. And it's a turnover to North Greenville as this one got past Claire Hoodling. Poppleton gets us back underway for North Greenville. Gets a pass to Taylor. And now Taylor is going to try to look to go deep down the field. She's under pressure, though. Now looks to number 15, Taylor Kennington. Kennington goes long down the field, overshoots Natalie Dufresne, and it's picked up by number 26, Leah Smith. Now here comes Michaela Knowles. She takes a check from behind from Hannah Hawkins, loses the ball, and now Hawkins in traffic gets called for an illegal cradle. So that'll give it to the Knights. Off the illegal cradle call, Megan Barfus brings it down the field for Southern Virginia. She'll get it to Whitworth. Whitworth heads to the far side, drives inside the box, and doesn't fire a shot, heads over to the far side, looking back. Still trying to drive in, has Pettit working against her. She'll get a pass off. Now here comes number 10, that's Bradshaw. She fires a shot and an easy save for Taylor as Bradshaw couldn't get full power behind that one. Taylor goes long, picks up Hawkins. Now to midfield. And here comes Sarah Smith. Actually, that's Natalie Dufresne. She'll lose the ball as she gets to the edge of the box. It's picked up by Kennington. Kennington now gets it to Sarah Smith. Smith trying to get position, sends Hawkins behind the goal. Kennington over to the near side. Smith joins Kennington over here on the near side. Now here's Kennington. After getting the pass from number 10, Emily Colson, back to Sarah Smith in the corner. Smith back behind the goal, has Dufresne. Dufresne looking down the middle, trying to pick up Caldwell. Well covered, she'll flip it back to Smith. Southern Virginia leaving some space in the middle now. Smith heading that way, passes outside the box to number 18, that's Hames, Taylor Hames. Goes back to Smith. Three players make it four behind the goal for North Greenville. They're stacking the near side. Here comes one moving, that's Hames. She has to head back. Here comes Hawkins stepping up. She has nowhere to go. Smith up top, trying to drive down the middle, runs into three defenders, goes near side to number 10, Colson. Now here comes Colson, gets around one defender. At number 10, that's Bradshaw, forces her to go around the goal. Now it's over on the far side with Kennington. Hames up top. Here comes Sarah Smith, open and got it. Sarah Smith strikes first for
Crusader
North Greenville. She'll
five.
Put the Lady Crusaders up
Sarah
1-0.
Smith.
That goal comes with 25-33 left to play here in the first half.
The Lady Knights decided to come out and play a man-to-man defense. The men's team the other night played a zone defense, and they got handled pretty easily. So these women playing a really hard man-to-man defense. They were very good, and Sarah Smith was just very lucky to get open in the middle there.
Now proving why she was last week's Conference Carolinas Player of the Week. Gets the first goal of the game. Back to midfield for the draw. Official steadying the ball. Backs out, and we're underway. Ball heads over to the far side. The Knights got the last one, and they'll get the ground ball this time. Number 26, Smith, gets that one for the Knights. Now across midfield goes Chloe Lewis to the near side for number 13, Ashley Algren. Algren on the near side, edge of the box, takes a check from behind by Caldwell. Caldwell scoops up the loose ball, and a whistle from the official behind Caldwell. Foul against the Knights, keeps the ball with North Greenville. Now here comes Sarah Smith across midfield, gets a pass off, but overshoots Hames. Hames going after it, now pulls up short as it rolls out of bounds on the far side, and Rainey Whitworth closest to it for Southern Virginia. Now Whitworth got some speed. She's outrun two North Greenville defenders, trying to outrun Sarah Smith. And Smith checks her from behind. And swatting at the ball, ground ball scooped up by North Greenville. And Colwell going down the field. Hames takes a check from number 10, Bradshaw. And Bradshaw gets called for that one. So North Greenville will start at midfield with the ball. Over to the near side comes Hames. Up top to Smith. Kennington and Hawkins go behind the goal. Over to the far side now for number 10, Colson. Now Colson, a little bit of space, gets it to Smith. Smith, nice stutter step there. Works inside and got a foul called again against Southern Virginia.
Sarah Smith's going to get that free shot. She's very good at this free shot.
Going up against the keeper, Miller. Here comes Smith. She'll fire a shot, and it goes in. So on that free shot, Sarah Smith cashes it in, the second goal of the game, and she's got them both. A 23-35 left to play here in the first half. Sarah Smith has North Greenville up 2-0.
Stand, stand, stand.
Candace Pettit and Emily Lamb at midfield for the draw. Official backs out. Ball swatted over to the near side by the Lady Knights. Bradshaw goes after it. And another ground ball for the moment. Scooped up by Bradshaw. Kennington collides with her. And after all that, number 17, Elizabeth Bonney, comes up with the ball. She gets it to Bradshaw. North Greenville almost had Southern Virginia trapped in their defensive end of the field. Now this ground ball goes across midfield, tracked down by number 15, Megan Barfus. And now here comes Whitworth in space down the far side of the field. Cuts it back to the middle, defended by Hawkins and Dufresne. Caldwell as well, spins around Caldwell, heads to the near side. Cuts back, flips a pass up top to number 10, Bradshaw. Here she comes, runs in to Pettit. She gets around two defenders, doesn't fire a shot. Heads around the goal, trying to find Whitworth. Ball swatted away in the air and picked up by number 10, Emily Colson on defense. Here she comes down the near side of the field, gets to midfield. Two defenders on her. And now Colson takes it down the near side of the field. A whistle will stop play. And a short reset, we're back underway. Pass up top. Ball scooped up by Dufresne. Dufresne to Kennington, in space, fires a shot, skips off the keeper's net and out of bounds. North Greenville closest to it. With Colson. She goes back up top, overshot Dufresne, it was coming right down the middle. Poppleton trying to track it down. And a stop play for a moment as Poppleton hit the turf. And that's a foul against North Greenville. The Knights will bring Barfus back to the point of the foul and restart. Barfus lobs it forward, looking for a Hoodling. Overshot her. And number 13, Elizabeth Carey, trying to track it down. And instead, it's scooped up by Michaela Knowles. Here's Knowles. She takes a stick check from behind by Caldwell. And Caldwell scoops up the ground ball. Flips it to Poppleton. Poppleton heads to the far side. Gets it to Hawkins. Now Hawkins back to the midfield. Dufresne. And Dufresne picks up Sarah Smith. Smith into some open space, into the box, fires a shot, bounces off the keeper's net again, and quickly scooped up by Leah Smith for the Knights. And Southern Virginia likes to take a timeout after a foul called against North Greenville. So Southern Virginia uses their first timeout of the game, 20-27. Left to play in the first half. North Greenville leading off of Sarah Smith's two goals so far. It's 2-0 here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Thank you. back here on the North Greenville Sports Network with Lady Crusaders leading the Lady Knights 2-0. About a third of the way here through the first half. The Knights attacking down the near side of the field with Whitworth. So far, the only two goals scored in favor of North Greenville from Sarah Smith. Here's Whitworth. Almost intercepted, and ball still loose. Whitworth goes after it and finally gets her pass back that was almost intercepted by Emily Colson. Now here comes Bradshaw. She slips and falls, hangs on to the ball though. Good cradle there by Bradshaw. She gets around Pettit, moves inside, takes a check from Pettit. And they will call Pettit for the foul. They pull her back outside the box. And gives Zoe Bradshaw some space. Looks like a free shot. Here comes Bradshaw, and Taylor makes the save again. Is it bounced off her net?
I believe they called no shot. There was a pushing foul on the way through, and they're giving the ball to North Greenville.
So North Greenville gets it back off the penalty call against the Lady Knights. Down the far side goes North Greenville. Whitworth on defense against Taylor Hames. Hames flips it inside the box. Here comes Sarah Smith. That's Kennington actually around the goal. Now here comes Pettit. She gets it back outside the box to Dufresne. And now it's with Colson. Here comes Sarah Smith after the pass from Colson. Skips outside the box, heads around Whitworth on the far side. Now Smith heading to the near side. Kennington over there. Colson heads around the goal. Hawkins sets up shot behind it. Smith on the left side of the box goes back up top as this pass skips backwards to Samantha Poppleton. Poppleton gets it back for North Greenville. Southern Virginia brings some pressure, but Poppleton escapes. Now here comes Poppleton trying to work around Whitworth. Skips around to the near side edge of the box. Whitworth sticks with her, and she is forced to pass back to Sarah Smith. Now, high pass brought down by Colson. Now she's bobbled it twice, three times. And foul against Southern Virginia. We'll keep it with North Greenville and Colson. She'll get it to Sarah Smith. Smith up top looking for some space. Can't find it. Gets around Whitworth, fires it to the far side, and Colson. Colson trying to spin around underneath, runs out of room. Now she'll fire a shot, skips off the keeper. And number 10, Bradshaw, trying to defend Colwell, and a yellow card comes out against Colson. A dangerous follow-through called against Colson.
Really tough to take that shot and not have that stick follow through and hit the defender.
That was Bradshaw that took the hit, but she's up and okay. In the meantime, a two-minute penalty for Colson. It's North Greenville forced to play a man down now, and the Lady Knights on the attack with Bradshaw back the other way. Into the box she goes, runs into the defender for North Greenville. And it looked like another offensive penalty against Southern Virginia. The Knights turn it over again. Pettit gets us back underway for North Greenville. They'll work down the field. Here's Hawkins at midfield. In traffic down the far side, bumps into Whitworth. And the quick foul called against Whitworth. Hawkins to Colwell. Colwell heading to the middle of the field. And now gets it back to Taylor Hames. Ames looking for Sarah Smith. Smith scoops it up. Smith has some space. And a foul away from the ball called against Southern Virginia. Moves number 17, Bonnie, outside the box. And now Smith lining up for another shot. She made one earlier. Here comes Smith, fires it wide right. No good. Hawkins closest to it for North Greenville. She'll go get it and send us back into, get us back underway. Hawkins gets out of the trap behind the goal and turns it over for the moment to number 5, Faith Park. A push called against number 15, Kennington. Make sure it stays with the Knights as North Greenville now back at full strength. Here comes Colson back onto the field. And number 5, Park, running down the near side. And Colson will have to come pick her up on defense. Colson takes, checks Park from behind, but Park gets the ball back. Flips it behind the goal to number 7, Hoodling. Over to the far side she goes, trying to get around Pettit. Forced back outside the box, gets a pass to number 11, Avery Bishop. Now here's Bishop. She takes a check from behind by Caldwell, and Caldwell scoops it up. Tries to get a pass to Dufresne, and it's picked up by Hames. She flips it back in bounds and almost had a nice pass back to Dufresne, but it's scooped up by the Lady Knights. Now here's Whitworth, moves into the edge of the box. Doesn't have much room to work with against Pettit, and this pass skips out of bounds intended for number 7, Hoodling. Turn it over to North Greenville. A bounce pass to Sydney Taylor, the keeper, and she'll look for the clear. Sails this one to Dufresne and skips off her net. Her net, and it's picked up by Whitworth. So Whitworth right back on the attack for the Knights. Skips a pass over to the near side for Bishop. And Bishop swarmed immediately by Colson, gets a pass back behind the goal, looking for Barfus back there. Well, Barfus doesn't have anywhere to go. Passes back up top to Whitworth. Whitworth looking to the middle. Has Hoodling there, but quickly swarmed and forced out to the near side. Now looking for Barfus again. Can't get it to go underneath. Hoodling gets it back, swings around the goal, looking for Bishop. That pass skips wide of her, and Whitworth swats it away from Kennington. And Whitworth gets it back. Whitworth nowhere to go. Now here comes a nice move inside, but the ball's bobbled by number 8, Chloe Lewis, and it's picked off by North Greenville. Pettit flips it forward down the far side of the field, trying to pick up number 33, that's Mackenzie Botts over there. Now there's a battle for it between Botts and Lewis. And a foul against Southern Virginia will keep it with North Greenville. Hawkins down the far side of the field in open space. All alone, though, at a disadvantage. Hawkins moves inside, cuts back to the middle, fires a shot, and bounces it off the ground and in.
Goal by number 7, Hannah Hawkins.
Well, when you're surrounded 3-1, what else do you do?
They did really well against that turnover on the far side. Gave the ball back to Greenville, and they had pretty much an open field right down to the net.
So Hannah Hawkins finds the back of the net for the third goal of the game, 12:23 left to play in the first half. Time called on the field, North Greenville leading Southern Virginia 3-0 here on the North Greenville Sports Network. here on the North Greenville Sports Network. The Lady Crusaders leading the Lady Knights of Southern Virginia University 3-0. Sarah Smith scored the first two goals. Hannah Hawkins just got the third one. And Southern Virginia is still very much alive in this thing as we close in on the end of the first half. 12:23 left to play until halftime. And back to midfield for the draw. It looks like North Greenville will be awarded with the ball after Lamb maybe flinched a little bit early. Botts on the far side of the box, gets it to Hawkins. Hawkins back outside to Dufresne. And Dufresne goes to Hames. Hames still in control outside the box, gets it to Kennington. Kennington flips it to Colson, and she misses wide left. Miller may have caught a piece of that one as it bounced out of bounds. Hawkins closest to it for NGU. Here comes Hawkins, makes a move inside, slings it around Miller into the back of the net.
Beautiful wraparound goal. We don't see that too much on the women's side.
And the only thing we can say for that draw was there was a foul on Southern Virginia. Doesn't say who, so the draw control automatically went to Candace Pettit. That was the situation for the last draw as Hannah Hawkins cashes in her second goal. She and Smith each have two. North Greenville leads it 4-0, 11:24 left to play in the first half. Pettit and Lamb back at midfield for the draw. Ball bounces into the defensive half for the Lady Knights. And the ground ball is picked up by NGU and Caldwell. And a foul against the Knights. We'll stop play for a moment. Keep it with Caldwell to Kennington. Now to Dufresne on the far side. Here comes Dufresne down the middle. We'll take a shot and skip it off the ground. And in. Natalie Dufresne picks up a goal.
Natalie Dufresne.
Her first of the game. And the fifth for North Greenville. So two quick goals right within 20 seconds of each other. And three goals in 2 minutes overall. North Greenville now leading 5-0. Starting to stretch their legs toward the end of the first half. And Pettit trying to get the draw control, and she will for North Greenville. Foul against Southern Virginia. Pettit just across midfield, swings over to the near side, sends Botts down the left wing, flips it back to Caldwell, working down the middle of the field. Here comes Caldwell, cuts it back left, slings it underneath. Here comes a shot from Hawkins, saved by Miller, but it bounced out. And Hawkins, fighting hard, scoops up the ground ball, gets it back to Caldwell. And Caldwell quickly boxed out. Now here comes Dufresne again. She'll sling a shot, and it's rejected by number 13, Algren. Now the Lady Knights with a chance down the field. Ground ball chased after and scooped up by Michaela Knowles. Knowles sticks to the right side. Has Whitworth and Bishop up top. Bishop now heads the far side. Now she cuts it down inside the box, bounces back out. Knowles still with it, looking for help, slings it underneath and nobody home. And it's deflected and recovered by Candace Pettit. Now Pettit overshoots her intended target. That was Colson. And now Hawkins comes back to help out, and she scoops up the ground ball. Has to scoop it. has to scoop for it twice. She gets it across midfield to Dufresne. Now to Kennington. Nice behind the back pass to Kennington. Here she comes. She'll fire a shot. And it's sent back out. And that one's actually recovered by Elizabeth Bonney. Dalt Miller had it, but nice interception there by Bonney. Now down the far side of the field, number 15, Megan Barfus for the Knights. The far side edge of the box defended by Pettit and Rebecca Bagwell. Barfus still has it. Now bounces outside of the box, looks to middle of the field, and Bradshaw goes to underneath to Whitworth instead. Here comes Whitworth, and Caldwell swats at her, trying to get the check. Can't do it. Whitworth hangs on to it, swings it out to the near side. Now forced to go back outside the box, passes up top. Here comes Bradshaw. Bradshaw runs into a host of defenders for North Greenville. And a foul is called. Another offensive foul against Southern Virginia. Colwell gets the ball for North Greenville and sends it down the field. Skips it to Kennington. And she picks up Hames. Has Hawkins running down the left side. Hames sticks to the middle. Now flips it to the far side. Overshoots Kennington, and it's picked up by Leah Smith. Smith down the field to Whitworth. And she continues the pass to Barfus. There comes Barfus underneath, overshoots her intended target, trying to pick up Hoodling, who was behind the defender. Ball's chased down by number 13, Elizabeth Carey for North Greenville. It gets it to her keeper, Taylor, and now North Greenville will try to counterattack down the far side. Here's Dufresne. Across midfield to Caldwell. Caldwell with a lot of room to run. Sticks to that middle lane, fires a shot and gets it around Miller to go. Good shot from distance for Monica Caldwell.
Can't say that was a set play, but that fast break worked out really well for the Crusaders.
Southern Virginia gave her a ton of space to work with, and she took advantage of it to get the sixth goal of the game for North Greenville. 6:59 left to play here in the first half. Back to midfield for the draw. Claire Hoodling now on the line for Southern Virginia, going up against Candace Pettit. Ball goes into traffic, and Hannah Hawkins comes back to control it for North Greenville. To the left side for Botts. Botts, the middle of the field, picks up Carey. That's Kennington. Kennington. Back behind the goal. Stutter steps her defender, gets it to Colson. Hawkins wide open, but shot it past to her right side. And now the Knights will have a chance to counterattack, but Caldwell comes in to scoop up the loose ball. And she flips it to the far side for Dufresne. Now here comes Dufresne. Drives in, now steps back out. She'll flip it to Colson. Now here's Kennington up top, bumps into Whitworth. And Whitworth, not giving her an inch, flips a pass to the far side for Colson. That one from Kennington. Now Colson looks for some room. Doesn't have much to work with as number 5, Faith Park, comes up. Now here she comes, flips a shot wide left. Now there's a scramble for it behind the goal. Caldwell scoops it up. She heads back around to the front side of the goal and forced back outside the box. Now trying to spin around her defender. She does so, drives inside, fires a shot again, skips it off the ground just wide left of the goal. And it looks like Kennington closest to it for North Greenville. Clock approaching 5 minutes left to play in the first half. North Greenville leading 6-0. Pass flip to Colson. Colson around the edge of the box. Flips it to the far side for Dufresne. Dufresne switches places with Colson. Looks back to the right side, gets it to Colson. Here comes Colson inside. Flips it and bounces it off wide right. And Hawkins goes after it for North Greenville. She'll get it. Play resumes with 4.5 minutes left. Here comes Hawkins behind the goal. Looking for help, has Hames to her right. She goes that way. Taylor Hames picks up Colson. Colson back outside the box to Dufresne. Has to go back to retrieve that one after it went off right side of her netting. Back behind the goal, now to Botts. Hawkins switches places with her. Now pass behind the goal, picks up Hames. Hames back behind the goal, trying to go for the swing around to Hawkins. She runs into a wall. And Whitworth scoops up the ground ball after it got away from Hawkins. Here comes Whitworth down the field, across midfield, heading into the attacking portion for the Lady Knights. Gets a pass to Hoodling. North Greenville trying to set up some defense of their own. And they left number 15, Barfus, open, and they catch a break after Hoodling overshot her. And now North Greenville heads back the other way. And that attack is stopped after the pass skips off out of bounds on the far side, intended for Botts. The Knights get it right back. Here comes Barfus down the far side edge of the field, cutting it back to the middle, a whistle. Possible offsides call against NGU. A good defense there by Candace Pettit to force the turnover at the edge of the box. Pettit airmails this one deep, picks up. It's number 18, Hames, with a lot of space, and tries to go back to the middle of the field for Hawkins, intercepted by Elizabeth Bonney. Bonney back the other way for the Lady Knights. Heads to the left side edge. Bobbles the ball. Here comes Pettit up. Gets a pass off in time to Leah Smith. Smith gets almost got intercepted by Caldwell. Got the pass off. Caldwell gets a check on Barfus. Barfus hangs on to it. Gets it to Whitworth. Time running out on Southern Virginia, looking for a goal here late in the first half. Whitworth trying to get around Pettit and Colson. And now goes up against number 13, Carey. We have another whistle. And a foul against NGU. Whitworth hangs on to it. Here's Whitworth. Has a pass deflected away by Carey. And another whistle behind the goal. And it's a foul against Southern Virginia. They'll put Carey with some space to work. And she'll get a bounce pass to Taylor. And Taylor cleared out. Taylor walks up, looks down the middle field, picks up Kennington. And Kennington bobbled it. Now there's a battle for it just shy of midfield. And Kennington comes back up to retrieve it, takes a check from Barfus. And now the Knights are going to try and get it. Kennington swats at it, still no good. And now the Knights finally control it with number 11, Avery Bishop. Bishop down the right side of the field, heads back to the middle of the field, bobbles it after Poppleton gives her a check. Slings it back to the near side for Barfus. Barfus cuts back to the middle. So we're under a minute to play here in the first half. Now North Greenville, good defense again. This time Pettit rips it away from Barfus. Gets a pass down the far side of the field. And now North Greenville transitions to Colson. Colson with a lot of room to run. Colson to the edge of the box. Gets inside, a whistle. And a foul against Southern Virginia at the edge of the box will give Colson some space. Clock stops with 22.6 seconds left. Here comes Colson inside, and it's in and good.
On the first half offensively, you can easily see that the Crusaders are using the long pass to get down the field, and the Lady Knights are using the legs and trying to outrun the defense. It's clearly not working for the Lady Knights. They're going to have to reevaluate this at halftime.
7-0 North Greenville after that goal from Emily Colson. Point 1 seconds left to play until halftime. Back to midfield for the draw. Ball popped up straight in the air, right into the hands of Whitworth. Whitworth back the other way, looking to take this one quick for the Knights. Heads back around the goal. Taylor adjusts her positioning. Now Whitworth jammed up by Carey, slings a pass, and here comes a shot that's bounced out by Taylor. And now this one's swatted in. Taylor again makes the save. After Knowles tried to get it on the rebound, couldn't get it to go. And Taylor will end the half for North Greenville with two fantastic saves to preserve the shutout.
At the half, Crusaders lead 7-0.
And at the half it is North Greenville 7, Southern Virginia nothing at the end of one. And we'll step away for halftime. And bring it back just before the second half gets underway with some news and notes. For the moment, North Greenville leading Southern Virginia 7-0 in non-conference play here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Back here for the second half, the North Greenville Sports Network, Southern Virginia taking on North Greenville. North Greenville shut out Southern Virginia in that first half, 7-0. And immediately take the draw with Candace Pettit. The tail of the tape says North Greenville out shooting Southern Virginia right now, and they may have another one. Here it comes, and yes it is. From number 13, Elizabeth Carey with the goal.
That was 15.
15, Taylor Kennington.
Well, that sounds like a halftime plan. Just come out and score right away with about 6 seconds into the second half. But it works. We appreciate you joining us on the North Greenville University Sports Network today. I am Dave Parson along with our play-by-play guy. Gray is doing a wonderful job as usual, and we thank you for joining us today.
So that quick goal makes it 8-0 North Greenville over Southern Virginia. Back to midfield for the draw. Southern Virginia has sent number 14, Emily Lamb, back up to take on Candace Pettit. And now the ball stuck between a couple of players. Knocked out, Natalie Dufresne trying to take a crack at it. This one's going to skip out of bounds. And awarded to Southern Virginia. Number 10, Zoe Bradshaw will get it. So that goal was credited to Taylor Kennington. That is her first goal of the game. Now the Knights trying to find their first as well. Here comes Whitworth. She has the speed to do it. She slings a pass right into the net of Taylor. Very interesting save for Taylor. That will be the fourth of the game for North Greenville. They had three in that first half. 17 shots to Southern Virginia's 4. North Greenville also has the edge in ground balls, 18-10. Both teams knotted up at 5 for the draw controls as the Southern Virginia managed to force the turnover, Leah Smith. And speaking of the turnover battle, it's very close. Southern Virginia with 15. And actually, North Greenville has tied that up as well at 15 with that latest turnover. Goals coming from Sarah Smith with 2, Hawkins with 2, Colson Caldwell each with 1, and Kennington getting her first to start off the second half, and Natalie Dufresne also getting a goal to start back in the first half. Lady Knights, in the meantime, in business, trying to find a way to get it around Taylor as Zoe Bradshaw takes a tumble and a foul against. Looks like Poppleton. So they'll back her up and give some space to Bradshaw. Here comes Bradshaw, and she's quickly boxed out. Stick check there from Caldwell. And the defender slips for North Greenville, trying to go after it. After Colson took a tumble. Ball given to North Greenville off the foul. Here comes Dufresne. Speeding down the middle of the field. Dufresne flips it to Kennington. Kennington, who just scored, looking for her second, and overshoots Hames on the near side. The ball skips out of bounds. We'll turn it over to the Knights, and a substitution made for North Greenville on that last exchange. Emily Colson comes off, and Natalie Hamrick comes in. Number 17, Elizabeth Bonney gets it into play, gets it to Aldgren. Now down the field looking for Megan Barfus. Dufresne gives him some trouble, trying to scoop up the ground ball at a disadvantage, 2-on-1, knocks it back across midfield. Dufresne does, still going after it, and Whitworth finally gets the edge and knocks it to Chloe Lewis. She gets it back, and now Whitworth bobbles it right in front of Botts. Whitworth again able to bail herself out and cross midfield, work down the far side of the field to number 7, Claire Hoodling. Hoodling spins around Hamrick into the box, gets around her twice, lobs it up, bounces to number 14, Emily Lamb, scooped up by Bradshaw. Here comes a shot that sails over the crossbar. And the flag comes out against Candace Pettit. So they'll bring Pettit. No major penalty against Pettit, but a free shot given to Zoe Bradshaw. Here comes Bradshaw. She'll bounce it, and it skips right in front of Taylor with another easy save. Sydney Taylor earns her 5th save of the game, and the freshman doing a wonderful job. Long pass is going to skip down the field, and Hannah Hawkins runs into Leah Smith at full speed. And Leah Smith will get the ball back for the Lady Knights. They'll put Hawkins behind her and restart with Knights in control. Just about 5 minutes into the second half, North Greenville leading 8-0. Whitworth down the far side. The leading scorer lobs a pass over the goal. And it's going to skip into the corner where Poppleton goes after it and scoops it up for North Greenville, but she's in some trouble going up against Barfus. She's able to get the pass to Taylor. And now Taylor, under duress from Hoodling, will get it out of trouble to Pettit. Now Pettit goes long down the field to pick up number 11, Colwell. Now down to number 15, Kennington. And here comes Dufresne. Now Hawkins. Hawkins already in the box with the ball, looking to try and get a shot. Will lob it around the two defenders and get it in.
Goal by number 7, Hannah Hawkins.
Beautiful shot, high right, right in the three hole, just over her left ear.
Hannah Hawkins will make it 9-0. And pick up her 3rd goal of the game. We'll give a hat trick for Hannah Hawkins for this game. That goal comes just over 5 minutes into the second half. 24-36 left to play. North Greenville now leading 9-0. At midfield for the draw, Pettit again facing off against Emily Lamb. Ball slung out right to Hannah Hawkins. Hawkins swarmed by 3 defenders, lobs it up to Dufresne here on the near side. Dufresne cuts it back to the middle. Now swings it back near side. Works her way already into the box. Will take a shot and skip it in. Good. And that was as easy as it could have gone for Dufresne. She puts 10 goals up on the scoreboard. And she will get a goal here in the second half. She got one earlier in the first half. So Dufresne with 2 on the day. Head coach for Southern Virginia, Nancy Weber, telling her team that they need to win a draw control here. And we have a whistle on the draw. And it goes to Hannah Hawkins, a North Greenville, also draw. Goes against Zoe Bradshaw, number 10, for Southern Virginia. So Hawkins gets it back, and we're underway. Hawkins runs into a wall, loses it, gathers it back, already driving inside, gets tripped up from behind. And Hawkins gets up okay. Foul against Southern Virginia will give Hawkins the ball over on the far side, away from the goal though, but she'll have space to drive in and try and take a shot. Here comes Hawkins, and she'll bounce it out and take a turn, lob a pass back to Caldwell outside the box. Now Caldwell in a foot race. No room down the middle, trying to make some. Here comes Caldwell inside. And before the shot was taken, foul called on the field. So they wave the goal off, but Caldwell gets it back with some open space, pretty much lined up with Miller and the goal. Here comes Caldwell. She gets a second chance and sling it down into the right side of the goal.
Seems rather obvious that the Crusaders have been working on that free shot. The defense just doesn't have time to get back over and block that when it's especially coming right out from the very center of the field.
Monica Caldwell with the 11th goal of the game for North Greenville. Southern Virginia calls timeout, 21-38 left to play here in the second half on the North Greenville Sports Network. Back here on the North Greenville Sports Network, the Lady Crusaders of North Greenville leading the Lady Knights of Southern Virginia 11-0. 21-38 left to play in the second half. On the draw, this one won by the Knights and number 11, Avery Bishop. She gets it to Whitworth, and Whitworth has been in control for the Knights so far, trying to run it down the middle of the field, gets around one defender, that's Colson. Now Whitworth heads to the far side. Whitworth all the way, chased all the way over to the far side, gets a pass underneath, and the first goal of the game for Southern Virginia from number 7, Claire Hudeling. We'll get the assist to Whitworth. So the Knights finally catch a break and they're on the board. And that is the fifth goal of the season for Claire Hoodling. One behind Megan Barfus with six on the board. Let's see if that's the jump start the Knights needed. They've still got 20 minutes left in this game.
Obviously, that timeout paid out well for them.
Kind of like in men's volleyball last night where call a timeout to try and swing the momentum. Looks like it worked in lacrosse here this time. Draw control goes in favor of North Greenville. Emily Coulson wins it for NGU, and now Botts turns it over, and it's scooped up by number 13, Algren on the far side. Now down the far side, Hoodling, who just scored for Southern Virginia, being chased by Coulson. And Coulson called for the foul. And this is going to give a lot of space to Southern Virginia to work with. Pass to Barfus at the edge of the box. Nowhere to go. Lobs it back to the far side to number 14, Emily Lamb. Lamb trying to get around Hamrick. Goes back behind the goal. Now almost chased out of bounds, and she is. So Hamrick will get us back underway. Waiting for the signal, she gets it, and Hamrick's off. And Hamrick lobs the pass, falls out of her netting. Now there's a scramble for it. And foul against Southern Virginia. After Hamrick lost it trying to pass. So Hamrick gets some help, slings a pass back to Caldwell. Now the ball comes out again. And Southern Virginia is going to be able to get it with good positioning. Now there's a collision in the corner between Poppleton and Bradshaw. And Bradshaw goes down. Yellow card comes out against Poppleton. So Bradshaw is going to be able to walk off under on her own power, but she'll head to the bench. And they call the penalty on Bradshaw. So she actually will take a seat for 2 minutes. And Poppleton will start us off for North Greenville. Gets it to Dufresne. Southern Virginia playing a man down. Dufresne forward to Coulson. Coulson with Kennington backing her up on the right. Coulson bounces a shot off of Miller, and it goes out of bounds. Who's closest to it? Southern Virginia is. Number 17, Elizabeth Bonney. And now this pass lobbed down the field, overshooting Barfus. Barfus going after it, though. Poppleton in quick pursuit. And Barfus brings it almost into the corner, bounces it back out. And back up to Whitworth. Whitworth gets around Caldwell and now underneath to Hoodling, but overshooting Hoodling just a little bit to Taylor. And we have a whistle as Taylor clears it. And the official counting players on the field. Inspecting an offsides call, but nobody offsides. So we're back underway. Taylor gets it down the field and a ways down the field. This one's going to skip out of bounds all the way on the far side. Botts couldn't bring it in. It'll be a turnover to Southern Virginia. Chloe Lewis gets it to Whitworth. And now Whitworth loses it, chasing after the ground ball, swatting at it. Hamrick goes after it for North Greenville. Whitworth comes out of the pile with it. And Whitworth trying to get around Hamrick. Here comes Caldwell on backup. And now here comes a shot. Skips off of Taylor's net from number 13, Algren, out of bounds. Southern Virginia closest to it. Lamb brings it in. Lots of back up to Whitworth. Here comes Whitworth. She'll fire a shot. And Whitworth has got a goal.
Question is now, do they have enough time to make a comeback? Looks like just under 16 minutes to go.
15:47 left on the clock here in the second half. The lead's been cut to 9. 2 goals scored by Southern Virginia. Rainey Whitworth gets it in alongside Claire Hudeling, and that is the 19th goal for Whitworth. So Lamb back on the line for Southern Virginia at midfield. Going up against Pettit. Ball taking a bounce to the far side and lost by Colson, and Colson goes back to get it. And now gets a pass to Pettit. Nice job by Pettit to scoop that one on the run. Pettit's off to the races. Brings it around to the near side, takes a check from behind, moves inside, a whistle. And a foul against Southern Virginia. We'll back Pettit up just a little bit. And she's going to line it up for a shot against Miller. Moving the last player into position. Here comes Pettit, moves inside, bounces it in. And yes, it did. Cross the plane in for a goal. Pettit with the goal. We'll get the increase the lead back to 10, 12-2.
Just a side note, also great. I noticed that Sarah Smith has not been in the game for a while. She's been on the bench icing a lower body injury, it looks like, and I believe she might be out for the rest of the game now.
So Smith out for at least the rest of the game for North Greenville. Crusaders making do in the time being, and a goalkeeper change for North Greenville. Sydney Taylor comes out, number 14. That is Lowry Gowing goes in. Gowing did get some play time against Erskine. And the draw at midfield, Pettit and Lamb. Ground ball scooped up by Dufresne on the run. Lobs it forward, trying to get it to Kennington. Can't find her. Leah Smith for the Lady Knights comes up to scoop it up. She goes down the field to Hudeling. And now Hudeling lobbing it long, overshooting number 15, Megan Barfus. And this one's going to bounce out of bounds and go back to North Greenville. Pettit gets us back underway. Pass to Poppleton. Poppleton lobs it across midfield, overshooting a mark intended for Hames. And now Southern Virginia is going to keep it in bounds and continue play. Bonnie goes after it and gets it. To Leah Smith and now to Chloe Lewis. Lewis down the field to Bishop. Bishop flips it across to the far side, Algren. Now Southern Virginia starting to pass a little bit more, and it seems to be working for them. They've managed to get 2 goals here in the second half. Algren on the far side, defended by Caldwell. Lobs it back to Bradshaw. Bradshaw up top, trying to spin around two defenders, bobbles it, gets it back. Bumped into Pettit and Hamrick. Now here comes Bradshaw. She loses it again, slips down trying to get it back. Hamrick goes after it for North Greenville as well as the keeper Gowering. A whistle will stop play.
Hey, when you get a break, tell Alan just to grab the computer from Jess for baseball. Thank you.
And the official coming in to check. And the yellow card comes in against number 10, Zoe Bradshaw. Unsportsmanlike conduct against Bradshaw.
I think that's her second call of the day, too. She's headed right to the bench, so she may be out for the rest of the game, too.
It follows like the rule of soccer where two yellow cards equal a red card. Well, they put a two-minute penalty up on the board against Bradshaw. She might be able to come back into this thing. In the meantime, the Lady Knights not done yet. Hoodling trying to get the ball back for Southern Virginia. And gets called for a foul. North Greenville will hang on to it. Down the far side of the field. In a foot race, Pettit tries to lob it forward. Lost it, and it's scooped up by number 6, Michaela Knowles. And now Knowles loses it out of bounds. Number 15 going after it, that's Barfus. And Hannah Hawkins will retrieve it for NGU. Lob it back to Pettit. Pettit to Caldwell. Caldwell at midfield. Brings it around to the far side. Runs through two defenders, trying to get around a third. Nice spin move there. Brings it to the middle of the field. Now at the edge of the box, moves inside, fires a shot. Off the keeper, Miller. Whitworth scoops up the loose ball. Now Whitworth lobs it forward. And the Knights will bring it back across midfield. It's Knowles into the attacking side for Southern Virginia. Now on the far side edge of the box. Natalie Hamrick working against Knowles. Knowles passes it back up top to number 15, Barfus. Barfus now under duress from Pettit. And penalty almost up against Southern Virginia, so the Lady Knights will be back at full strength. They did bring a player in, however, it was not Bradshaw, so Bradshaw looks like she will be done for the day. And that looks like a 19. Jersey's a little bit bunched up, but Amanda McCafferty in, as well as number 9. That is Kafia Abdullahi. Under 10 minutes to play in the second half, North Greenville leading 12-2. And another offensive foul against the Lady Knights. We'll give the ball to Pettit. She'll lob it forward, trying to find Kennington. Kennington takes a check, bobbles it, and scooped up by Avery Bishop. Now Bishop loses it. And a foul against Kennington, battling over there on the far side against Bishop. Lady Knights back in business on the far side edge of the box. Number 11, that's Bishop. Eludes one defender. Pettit coming after her. Gets her around her a second time. Bishop lobs it up. Gets it to Lamb. Now Hawkins comes after Lamb. Lobs it back to the far side for Barfus. Now Barfus looking to try and bring it down the middle. North Greenville forming a wall of three defenders, forcing Barfus to stay outside. Trying to get around Hamrick. Hamrick stays in position. This shot lobbed up for Whitworth. She brings it down. Here comes Whitworth inside, spins, fires a shot, bounces it off of Gowring. Ground ball battled for and scooped up by the Lady Knights. Number seven, Hoodling gets it. Trying to spin around Dufresne. Drives inside from the near side of the box, goes across and looking for Whitworth. A little too tall for her, and this is going to go all the way across the field and roll out of bounds and go back to North Greenville on the turnover. Hawkins brings it in and overshoots number six, Bagwell. Now there's a scramble for the ground ball just shy of midfield. North Greenville comes out of it with Kennington. Gets it to Dufresne. Dufresne eludes a couple of defenders, one of those being Whitworth. And now here comes Dufresne running past everybody. Pulls up in the box, fires a shot. And it's stopped by number nine, Abdullahi, and given to the keeper, Miller. Now over on the far side, Southern Virginia with Knowles. Lobs it back to Lewis. Now number 17, Bonnie. Bonnie brings it across midfield, lobs it down the middle field, picks up Hoodling. Hoodling has back up to her left and right. Four players to her right. Now looking in the middle has number 14, Lamb, crossing in front of the goal. Hoodling hangs onto it for the moment. Looking to try and drive inside, opposed by Caldwell and Dufresne. They're trying to move Whitworth inside. Here comes Whitworth on the shot, skips it wide left. And the Knights will hang on to it as Lamb closest to it. Lamb will bring it in. Give it to Bishop. Bishop on the near side. And give it back up top to Barfus. Now Barfus will look for some room. Trying to drive in left. Hamrick is there in her way. Lobs it up for number 11, Bishop. Sails it to her left. It's loose ball scooped up by Hawkins. And a whistle and a yellow card comes out against Southern Virginia. Number 15 coming off. That's Megan Barfus. Got a slashing call. So 2 minutes for Barfus. And there's 6:02 left to play. Hawkins long down the field trying to hook up with Hames. Overshoots her, and Leah Smith will track it down for Southern Virginia. Smith trying to get around everybody. Loses the ball. And a foul calling against North Greenville as Smith was trying to evade Hames and Colson. Southern Virginia hangs on to the ball. They cross midfield, pass to Whitworth. Here comes Whitworth down the far side of the field. She's got 1-2 goals for the Knights so far. And a whistle as Whitworth trying to spin inside. Foul against North Greenville. And Whitworth given some space. She'll try to move inside. Here she comes, fires a shot, bounces it off Gowring, and scooped up by Hamrick. Hamrick loses it after taking a check from behind, goes after it again, gets it back. Defenders giving chase for Southern Virginia. Hamrick lobs it up and gets it to midfield, but where it's scooped back up by the Knights for the moment. Now there's a scramble for it in front of the scores table, and Colson comes away with the ball. Colson gives it to Kennington. Kennington heads to the far side of the field. Lobs it back to Caldwell. Caldwell trying to drive inside. Nowhere to go for her. She's being driven back by Algren. And now foul against Algren, working against Caldwell. Caldwell gets it to Kennington. And And full strength back up for Southern Virginia. Swing it around for North Greenville, around the goal to Dufresne. Now to Hames. Hames back around the goal to the other side. Takes a check from Whitworth, gathers it back. Hames still back behind the goal. Lobs a pass to Poppleton. Poppleton looks back to Colson. Now Colson looking for some space. Bumps into Algren. And a timeout called by North Greenville as Colson was trying to work to the far side of the edge of the box. Timeout called with 3:18 by North Greenville left to play here in the second half. Lady Crusaders trying to put this one away. They lead it 12-2 here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
Appears to me as if North Greenville Crusaders are just trying to run the clock down now. Pretty happy with this 10-goal lead. And take a short break here, and we'll be right back.
Back here on the North Greenville Sports Network, 3:18 left to play in the second half. North Greenville trying to finish this one out against Southern Virginia University out of the Capital Athletic Conference and Division III for the Lady Knights, which they joined back in 2013. And North Greenville stepping out of conference play before they get back into their conference schedule. They lead here 12-2. And Whitworth with the interception off of Poppleton. And now Whitworth with a lot of space. She's got one today for Southern Virginia. Whitworth trying to lob it up. This one deflected by North Greenville. Pettit got a piece of it, and she'll scoop it up. Pettit lobs it to Colson. Colson able to elude one defender, fire a pass across midfield, looking for Kennington. Now there's a scramble for the ground ball. Whitworth scraping at it, as well as Colson. And Kennington, after all that, finally comes up with it. And trying to find Hawkins and sends it out of bounds on the near side, trying to connect with Hawkins. Be a turnover to Southern Virginia. Bonnie sends it back in. Goes to Barfus. Now here comes Barfus at the edge of the box for Southern Virginia. Lobs it in. That one deflected by a North Greenville defender intended for Hoodling, who was open in the middle. The Knights get it back. Now Hudeling still in the middle, has Hamrick working against her. Over on the far side with number six, Knowles. And she has Poppleton to contend with. Lobs it around back behind the goal. And here comes number seven, that's Hudeling, trying to go to Whitworth, who was opened in the middle, had a one-on-one with Gowring. And the Knights scoop it back up. They'll have a third chance. It's with Knowles again as Colwell comes up to pressure her. And Southern Wesleyan called, or Southern Virginia called for the foul. Final minute here of the second half. North Greenville leading 12-2. Can try and run the clock out here. Colwell brings it across midfield. Looks like North Greenville still playing hard. This one deflected by number eight. Lewis got a piece of that one. North Greenville got it back. We might have a chance for one more final shot. Kennington tracks it down over here to the near side. Being pressured by Abdullahi. Now here's Colson, lobs it, trying to get it to Poppleton. Poppleton had it deflected away. Now Colson scrambling for it right at the edge of the box, and the Knights knock it away with number 13, Algren. Still, ground ball still loose. Poppleton finally wins the battle, lobs it, and here comes a shot that skips wide right from Colwell, and that will run us to the end of the game. It's North Greenville. Wins it 12-2 over Southern Virginia. And they pick up their fourth win of the season. North Greenville moves to 4-3. And Southern Virginia falls to 3-3, 500 overall on the season.
Very well played game today. Both teams really showed a lot of heart. Crusaders coming up on top. Players are now ready to congratulate each other at midfield. Again, it was a very hard-fought game, very good defense, especially on the Greenville side when they boxed up. They usually come up with about three players in a box, and it kind of stopped any kind of aggression that the Lady Knights had, but they certainly played a very well game.
And so later on today, baseball team will be taking on Newberry as they look to get back on the winning side of things. Their 11-game winning streak snapped against Anderson earlier in the week. And then we will be back broadcasting what might decide your regular season champion for the Conference of Carolinas. North Greenville welcoming Mount Olive to Tigerville for a three-game series. Friday night game now moved to 6 p.m. And the doubleheader stays at noon for that series against Mount Olive. For this game here, North Greenville scored 12 goals on 26 shots. Southern Virginia got 2 on 11 shots. North Greenville managed to save 5 shots. Southern Virginia got 9. 29 ground balls for the Lady Crusaders, so the Lady Knights 21. And a decisive advantage in draw controls for North Greenville, 10-6. And North Greenville actually lost the turnover battle, 27-25. But they come away with a victory. Goals for Southern Virginia, Whitworth with 1, and Hudeling also with 1. And for North Greenville, it is Sarah Smith with 2 early goals back in the first half. Hannah Hawkins earned the hat trick with 3. Colwell got 2. And Dufresne got 2 more as well. So we'll see you back Friday just across Highway 414 for the baseball series against Mount Olive. And thanks to Dave Parsons for coming back on, Alan Cahaley, Alan Ellis, and for myself, Gray Southern, this has been the North Greenville Sports Network.